Good morning dear student, welcome back to the class. Today I am here with your second unit buildings. Okay, before I start this class I want to ask a question. Dear student, what do you see in your surroundings? You can see different types of flowers, birds, trees and different types of vehicles, buildings. Also you can see more people. Okay, so buildings means, is it only houses? No. Buildings, that means it can be hospitals, shopping mall or different types of offices and also varieties of houses you can see in your surroundings. So, dear student, let us start the second unit, buildings. Buildings, okay. So, the poem, Roofs, it is a poem. It is about a black bird. It belongs to True family. So this lesson was written by a great and England poet. His name was Jane Euphemia. He was born in 1811 and he was died in 1898. So first I introduce the new words from this poem. Roofs, that means a black bird of the crow family. Kagi chhatige serde ondu pakshi. It is looking like crow. Okay, its color is black. So it is a black bird of the crow family. It belongs to crow family. Labor, that means work hard. Crooked, not straight, bent. See dear student, I will show the sticks. This is straight. Is this straight? No, it is bent, curved. So it is not straight. This is called as crooked stick. Next one, slender. Slender, that means thin. Tumba thildaneya. Like this type of woody piece. Next one, twig. A small dry woody piece fallen from the branches. Rembe, kombe. It is a small type of woody piece. It is fallen from the branches. So next one, tuft. That means a piece of hair or grass, like this. A piece of hair or grass. Okay, next one, moss. A very small green or yellow plant. Yellow plant, green, pachi. So like that, it is a very small piece of yellow or green plant. Okay, let us start the poem. I will show a nest. What is this, dear student? This is a nest. Yes, it is a home of birds. Okay, let us start the poem. The roofs are building on the trees. They build there every spring. Where the birds build their nest? Yes, the birds build their nest on the trees. Buildings, that means it refers to nest. The birds build their nest on the tree. So the roofs are buildings on the trees. Buildings refers to nest. The roofs build their nest, build their home. Where commonly you have observed in your surroundings, the birds are building their nest on the tree. So here also the rooks, that means it is a black bird belong to crow family. It is build their nest on the tree. Okay, next one, they build their every spring. What's the mean spring? Yes, spring, it is a name of a season. It is name of a season. That means dear student, vasanta kala. So commonly the birds are sings in spring season and also they build their nest on the tree commonly in spring season. So the roofs also build their nest on the tree and they build their every spring. Every, that means prati vasanta kaladallu abhayan madutte tanna goodugalanna kattutte. The roofs build their nest in every spring. Cow cow is all they say. Have you heard the sound of cow cow? Yes, it is a cry of crow. So it is sings like cow cow. For none of them can sing. It can't sing anything. It's only sing cow. cow cow. How the rooks are sing? The rooks are sings like cow cow. It for none of them can sing. That means it can't sing anything. It's only sing like cow cow. Okay. Yes, student. I hope you understood the first stanza. First stanza. The rooks are building their nest on the tree, and they build there every spring. Spring, it is the name of a season. In every spring, the rooks build their nest. Where the rooks build their nest? The rooks build their nest on the tree. Okay, dear student. Cow cow is all they sing. All day, whole day, it is sings like cow cow. For none of them can sing. It can't sing anything. It only sings like cow cow. Okay. In second stanza, they are up before the break of day. Break of day. That means before the break of day. That means sunrise. Sunrise or at morning. It up before the morning. Belagaguva munche morning. It up before the break of day. It up before at the sunrise. Sunrise agaku munche en martta ittu elta ittu. See, they are means the rooks are up. The rooks are wake up echchara bolodu. The rooks wake up before the break of day, before the sunrise, and up till late at night. Yes, up till late at night. It can't sleep at daytime. It's up till late at night. It works hard. The rooks are very hard worker. They all can't sleep. They are up late, up before the break of day and up till late at night. Okay, it sleep late at night. Tumba tadaraathiyagi iden martta ittu malagta ittu. And for the most labor busily, that means work hard. It is a hard worker. Who is hard worker? The rooks. The rooks are hard worker, and it is very busy in day till night, and long as it is light. It is very busy till the end of the day. End of the day, that means late night. So the rooks are up before the break of day. It is up before. It is wake up before the sunrise, and it is up till late at night. It can't sleep in daytime. It is sleep at late at night. Tumba tadaraathri agi malagtaayitu. And for the most labor busily, it is very busy. As long as it is light, it is very busy till late at night. Okay, it is very busy end of the day. Yes. Next, in the third stanza, and many a crooked stick they bring. Why it is very busy? Yes, it is very busy because of collecting crooked sticks, slender twig, tuft of moss. Okay, dear student, I show the pictures. Crooked sticks, that means this type of sticks. It is not straight. It is crooked, bent, curved. Okay, next one. Crooked stick and slender twig. Slender twig, that it is a small woody piece fallen from the branches, and it is very thin. And third one, tuft of moss. So that means this type of stick. It is a, here I wrote, the very small green or yellow plant. The rooks, it is very busy to collecting slender twig and crooked stick and tuft of moss. For until elli varugu ad collect martta itto. Yes, it is very busy to collecting crooked stick, slender twig, tuft of moss until their nest become round and big. So their nest become round and big like this. When the rooks become round and big, it is very busy to collecting crooked stick, slender twig, and tuft of moss. So how is the nest? The rook's nest is very beautiful and it is very big and it is round. It is in shape, round shape. It is very big. So the rooks are build their nest with the help of collecting crooked stick, slender twig and tuft of moss. How is the rook's nest? The rook's nest is very round and big. It is very beautiful. Okay, dear student, let us start the fourth stanza. Cow, cow, cow. What a nice noise. That means sound. In the first stanza, I have told you, the crow sings like cow, cow, for none of them can sing. It can't sing anything. It only sings like cow, cow. So, cow, 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 what a noise. It is a beautiful sound they make in rainy weather. When they sing, yes, it is sing in rainy weather. Male baruva time, male ghala, yes, rainy season. It is sings in rainy season. You have observed in your surroundings, dear student. Commonly, birds are sings in rainy weather. So, it's a very beautiful sound. So, they make in rainy weather. The cow, 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 what a noise. It is a beautiful sound. It can hear in rainy weather. Good children always speaks by turns. What's the mean turns? One by one. Turns, that means one by one. So, good children always speaks by turns. You have observed in your class. When I ask question, you tell the answer like one by one. Because you are a good student. So, like here also, good children always speaks by turns. You are always speaks one by one. Ubradmantra, ubrahetira, classal. So, like the good children always speaks one by one. But rooks all talk together. That means vanga thagi. The rooks all talk together. One day, they all, at a time, they all, rooks talk together. So, they are talking in group. That means it's not good because it's creating a more sound. Most, yes, it is creating more noise. So, good children always speak by turns. Like one by one, the good children tell the answers in your class. So, but here, the rooks all talk together. They all, at a time, they all talk together. They all are talking group. Okay, dear student, I hope you all understood this lesson. Again, I repeat it. The rooks are building on the tree. That means all rooks. Rooks means it is a blackbird belongs to crow family. Their buildings refers to nest. The rooks build their nest on the tree. They build their every spring. The rooks build their nest in every spring. Spring, that means it is a name of a season. Okay, cow cow is all they say. The rooks sings like cow cow. It is all day sings like cow cow, for none of them can sing. It can't sing anything, it only sings like cow cow. They are up before the break of day. When they wake up, who? They refer to rooks. The rooks are wake up before the break of day. At early morning, it wake up and up till late at night. It can't sleep in daytime. It up till late at night. That means it can sleep late at night. And for the most labor busy, it is very busy. So, it can't sleep in daytime. It is very busy as long as it is light. Where the end of the day, it is can't sleep. For the end of the day, it can sleep. Okay. And many a crooked stick they bring. The rooks brought different types of crooked stick. Crooked sticks and slender twig and tuft of moss. It is very easy to collecting crooked stick and slender twig and tuft of moss for until their nest are round and big. It is busy to collecting these types of sticks for becoming their nest round and big. It is become a like this type. It is become to like this type, round and big shape. And cow cow, oh what a nice, nice, that means shabda. It seems like in the first stanza I have told the crow or the rooks sings like cow cow. It can't sleep anything, it only sings cow cow. It is a very beautiful sound. It is very nice. So they make in rainy weather. When they sing in rainy weather. Good children always speaks by turns. Good children always speaks one by one. But here rooks all talk together. Yet a time all rooks talk together. The rooks all talk in groups. Okay, dear student. Next one. I ask some question. So you try to give answer orally. How is the rook's nest? Yes, tell me. The rook's nest is big and round shape. It is very big and round shape. See here, it is looking like round shape. Okay, dear student. Next one. How the rooks build their nest? The rooks build their nest with a crooked stick and slender twig and tuft of moss. How or rooks sing? Yes, the rook sings like cow cow. It can't sing anything, it only sings like cow cow. When they wake up at before the day. That means before the break of day. It wake up early in the morning and it can sleep at late at night. It is very busy. Okay, dear student. How the good student talk in your class? Yes, the good students talk or speak in your class by one. But here the rooks all talk together. Okay, here in your textbook they mention some of the fill in the blanks. Okay, with the help of picture, see dear student, they give some of the pictures also here. These are clues for your answer. So look at the picture, try to give correct answer. In the first picture, what is it? It is a nest. In the second picture, tree. So the rooks build their nest on the tree. In the first, fill in the blanks, you fill the nest. Because the picture, what is in picture? The picture is nest. The rooks build their nest on the tree. Second one, they are up before. It is sunrise picture. So it is before the break of day. Here I wrote the rooks up before the break of day. In the third one, they build their nest with dash. What? With a crooked stick. They mentioned a slender twig and tuft of moss. So in the fill in the blanks, you will fill the crooked stick. And fourth one, their nest look dash and dash. How are the rooks nest? The rooks nest are round and big. So in the fourth column you fill the round. And next one, they all talk dash. The words commonly talk together. So in the last fill in the blanks you will fill the they all talk together. Okay, dear student, I hope you understood this poem. If you have any doubts, ask me in comment box. Okay, dear student, and I will send the notes of this lesson through WhatsApp. Okay.